First things first, we're going to cover the basics, the absolute four basic things you need right now to start your ATM business. After that, we actually have a real estate investor. He's doing phenomenal in the real estate game, but he made a pivotal decision in his life. He is actually going to cover how to make four figures monthly from your ATM business. And to wrap it up, Paul's going to cover how ATM automation will allow you, like literally you right now, buy back your time, guys.
Hey guys, this is Paul Alex from ATMtogether.com. I'm here with my co-host, Getem Yonis. How's everyone doing today?
What's going on, guys? Man, it's Tuesday. It's cold. I just got back from the Bay, man. I'm freezing. How are you guys doing?
Man, so how was the Bay Area?
It was cool, man. It was cool. I literally just got back yesterday, but it was like 45 degrees. I know you guys in the East Coast are probably laughing right now, but 45 degrees, man. I'm not ready for that. I'm like a peach. I'm for the warm weather. Other than that, it was nice though.
Man, I miss that weather, man. I mean, I love San Diego guys, but you know, I'm always going to rep San Francisco guys. I'm used to that cold weather, you know, but all right, guys, let's go ahead and get started with the show. So I want to welcome you guys to ATM Business for Beginners. This is the largest ATM niche group on Facebook, guys. I think we're at like 47,000 now. My goal is to get us to 50,000 by the end of the year, guys. And if that happens, then my birthday is on January 18th, guys. Take note, my birthday is on January 18th. I will do a special raffle, okay? I'm not going to say what I'm going to give, but I'll do a special raffle if we hit 50,000 members, okay? So make sure to tell your loved ones, family members, anyone you know about this group. Awesome. All right, so to continue with that, guys, what city and state you're from? We want to get to know you. This is an interactive live, guys. This is not a recorded webinar. You might see a little bit of mistakes. Hey, go ahead and laugh. Hey, we have fun with this, guys. We love doing this 1 hour a week. And it just gives us times to basically debrief with you guys how the week went and all that jazz.
For sure, guys. I'm seeing some people comment below. See Vegas. 60 degrees in Vegas. That's like perfect right now. And I see Eileen in Cali. You know you're from Cali when you say Cali, right? But if you guys are watching this live, comment live below. We want to see where we're reaching out to and exactly where, because we want to make sure when we get that next raffle, what's going to be relevant to you, okay? And then, of course, if you're watching us on replay, maybe you're at work, maybe you're commuting, maybe it was snowing and the road is blocked, just comment replay below and we will reach out on the back end again. Remember, this helps us with the algorithms on Facebook, because the more you comment, the more people this reaches out to. And it may be that merchant that wants an ATM that you guys connect with, guys. So comment below, all right?
No, absolutely, guys. Absolutely. And get them. When I do this announcement, guys, we're going to do a few announcements. We got a lot of things on the pipeline. I'm like so pumped right now because you guys don't understand. Like, this is going to be another milestone starting December 1st. All right. I already told you guys to remember my birthday, January 18th of 2023, right? But you got to remember December 1st, because December 1st, we're about to change the game in the ATM industry. Mark my words, guys. Okay. We're working on it right now, working day and night, but we're going to make it happen for you. Okay. Now, a few announcements, guys. Next Monday. All right. We've been getting blown up by a ton of messages regarding vending machines. All right. And no. We're not doing vending automation, guys. Okay. I know some people got excited there. They're probably like, oh, are they finally going to do it? If we are, it's going to be with this partner. Okay. This partner I'm about to announce real quick. But I'm going to be live on IG with my girl Kwani Bates from Rezo Vending. So we met Kwani online on IG. She caught our interest because of her content, how hardworking she is. She's a mother, serial entrepreneur, and she organically was able to grow her Instagram, guys, to over 114,000 followers, which is amazing. I mean, that's unheard of without having a marketing team. So she does it all. Quite impressive, okay? So, you know, I had to shoot my shot, and I was like, Kwani, we should collab because I have a ton of clients and also members within ATM Business for Beginners that are super interested in vending machines. And she's like, yeah, let's rock. So we're going to bring it to you guys live on IG next Monday, November 21st of this year at 5 p.m. Pacific Central Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, guys. It's going to be remarkable. We're going to treat it like a live. It's going to be interactive. So two things you need to do right now, and then get them. See if you can help me out or any of the ATM Together staff watching right now, okay? What I need you guys to do, get them, and the staff is going to drop the actual IG handles, okay? So if you're not following me on Instagram, and if you, and I'm not going to take that excuse, guys. I don't got an IG. No, trust me. I wasn't on social media for 7 years. I finally made I finally made a YouTube, okay?
Yeah.
Without any videos, but I made it, okay? So if I could do that, you guys could take 2 minutes to make an IG. So follow me, Paul Alex Espinoza at IG. And then also follow Kwani Bates. Her IG is going to be Razo Vending, and that's going to be RayzoVending, guys. Make sure you guys follow us because we're going to be giving out updates. We're going to be shooting out the flyer starting tomorrow. It's going to be remarkable, guys. So you guys are going to get literally a free masterclass on vending machines and ATMs. It's going to be cool. So make sure to invite everybody you know.
That's going to be phenomenal. Paul, I actually have something else I want to share because you brought something up, right? And if you can enable the share screen, because you thought about vending, right? That's another opportunity. They complement ATM businesses. Just so you guys know, we're all about passive income, whether it's ATMs or not. So vending machines make sense. Well, we actually got notified of something else going on. So let me see if I can show this. I'll pull up the website. So let me ask you guys this, all right? So how many of you guys would actually like to take a cruise to the Bahamas? First of all, I already know that's going to be a yes, but what if you're able to learn from multimillionaires about literally creating passive income and other streams of income for yourself, your friends, and your family? If that sounds like something you'd be interested in, comment cruise below, C-R-U-I-S-E, cruise. What we're going to have is Teach Week Investor Cruise. Check it out. It's actually teachweekinvestor.com. It's actually happening on May 14th to May 18th of next year. We're planning out that far ahead. Ready, guys. Get ready. So we're going to be going from Palm Beach, Florida, because you know how much we like Florida, all right? From Palm Beach, Florida to the Bahamas. If you haven't been to the Bahamas, if you haven't been on a cruise, it's okay. But what you're going to be able to do is learn on that cruise, okay? So check out the website. It's actually going to be 20% off until this Friday. ATM Together, we're actually going to be there. We're going to be talking about a few different things, ATMs and some other secret things we're going to announce on that cruise also. And we're going to be doing a free masterclass, literally a free presentation in front of thousands of people, thousands of entrepreneurs that want to get started in the business also. I mean, I hope to see you guys there. It's going to be phenomenal, guys. Man.
Yeah, absolutely, guys. I mean, like, get them, hit all the main points for this, but make sure you guys do not miss this. Okay. They just launched the tickets yesterday. All right. So what they're doing is the promoter for this Teach Week cruise, they hit us up and they see the value that we provide to literally tens of thousands of people every single week, guys. All right. So they asked us, hey, you need to jump on this cruise and educate all these entrepreneurs that are jumping on here and trying to invest in themselves and also trying to generate other sources of income in 2023. So it's going to be remarkable, guys. Some of the listings on the website, if you guys are looking through it right now as I'm speaking, crypto, ATMs, vending, credit repair. It's going to be cool. Like, I can't wait to see these other presenters present. But then you're also going to be able to meet us. We're going to have a booth. We're going to have some free giveaways, a ton of giveaways, actually. And we're going to set it up and, you know, hook you guys up. But for this week only, guys, they have a pre-sale. Okay. So if you want to jump the gun right now, grab your ticket, secure your ticket, because it's going to sell out, guys. I'm telling you right now, it's going to sell out. That's why they're going and they're promoting this 6 months, literally 6 months in advance. Yeah. So that tells you something, okay? It's going to be huge. They haven't even started the marketing campaign. And trust me, when we talked, they're going to drop hundreds of thousands of dollars on the marketing campaign. So right now they're going to the speakers and they're like, look, reach out to your audience first and offer them the pre-sales because the pricing is going to go up. I'm telling you guys, all right? So I don't want you guys to miss it. I know we have a ton of people in the East Coast. Yeah. And I know all my New Yorkers, they like Florida. Trust me, I've been there enough where I met a ton of New Yorkers, all right? So all my New Jersey, New Yorkers, Connecticut. Yeah, Gianni, I see you. Come down to Florida, take a little cruise to the Bahamas, learn a little something, have some fun. And then ultimately, hey, your network is your net worth, guys. So it's 20% off before this Friday. You guys could check out the website, talk it over with the spouse, with the family, and make those plans. And I'll see you guys there.
That's what I'm talking about. And you guys get a 6-month notice. It is time to start working out now because I'm going to see you on the beach. I'm going to call you out. All right. So I can't wait to see you guys.
I already started that. If you guys start following me on IG, you'll see every single morning my trainer, who's like 6'3", 260 pounds, right? Mike, this dude don't play. He's like, hey, I'll see you at the gym in 30 minutes. And it's like 5:30 in the morning. I'm like half asleep. I'm like, oh man, I still got to walk my dog. I still got to take my pre-workout. I still got to do this. trust me, guys, it's not cool waking up that early, but at the end of the day, I got to get it done. Okay. Health is wealth. It doesn't matter how much money you make, because if you're unhealthy and you're dying in your bed or you pass away, guess what? You're not going to be enjoying that money. Right. So exactly. I got to go ahead. I got to take care of myself. I'm about to be 35. I know a lot of people are probably like 35 ain't that old. Hey, trust me, when my parents and my 20s were like, hey, you're going to get old just like us, believe us. I was like, no, I'm going to be young forever. Right. Hey, I'm here now. Right. So I'm feeling it.
Exactly. Exactly. We got to get to it. It is already, man. We're a few minutes in. We're running behind, guys. So let's get to it. Okay. So tonight we have a phenomenal presentation. Like, I'm talking like this is cream in the crop, guys. You're going to be in for a treat. So first things first, we're going to cover the basics, because at the end of the day, you got to understand the basics of what you're doing. I'm a firm believer of you knowing the foundation of what you're getting into, and then you can scale. So we're going to cover the beginner basics, literally the four pillars, the absolute four basic things you need right now to start your ATM business. After that, we actually have a real estate investor. He's doing phenomenal in the real estate game, but he made a pivotal decision in his life. Kurt Davis. He is actually going to cover how to make 4 figures monthly from your ATM business. And to wrap it up after that, guys, we actually have something special after. Paul's going to cover how ATM automation will allow you, like literally you right now, buy back your time, guys. So it's going to be phenomenal, but I'm going to actually let Paul start it off right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, Gadam. So guys, 4 pillars to the ATM business. Now, typically we go ahead and we just jump into it. We go LLC, business bank account. We go into going to ATM and processing suppliers. But for this training, I actually wanted to do it a little bit different. And the reason why is because we're getting into the holidays. And let's keep it real. If any of us were trying to start a business right now, how many of you guys are actually going to start during Christmas? Right? That's something that you really, really have to plan out. Especially because we're going into a new year. And what does everyone always say when there's always a new year, guys? There's a new year and a new me, right? But we want to make sure we execute, okay? Because trust me, in my 20s, in my past, I have said that several of times. And I have let myself down several of times, guys. But not this year. If you're saying that to yourself, not this year. This year is going to be your year, guys. And I'm talking about 2023. I'm not talking about 2022. It's almost over. It's crazy. It's crazy. I think we only have about, 45 days left? Think about that. 45 days left. And you're going to get 1 year older. You're going to have to repeat all your family's birthdays. You're going to have to repeat all the holidays. We're going to have to go through summer. We're going to have to go through all the holiday parties. We're going to have to go through all the annual festivities. And if nothing changes, what do you have to look forward to? Think about that, guys. When you start your business, and this is why I love entrepreneurship, okay? When you start your business, you actually look forward to going and creating something for you and your family. For you in here, okay? You're not going to build something for your boss or for the CEO of that company anymore. It's all for you. So ultimately, as you do those steps, step by step, and you're building, ultimately, even if it's one step at a time, how many days out of the year, guys? 365 steps, right? So if you were to take one step or work 1 hour a day, okay, discipline every single day, that adds up to a lot, guys. 365 steps, 365 hours. At the end of the day, it's ultimately you versus you. And that's what you have to realize, okay? It's none of us. We're actually here to help. We have the social proof. We have the results. There are members in this group that started where you started at. And ultimately, they were scared. They were scared like I was scared, like Adam was scared, like Mike was scared, like the rest of the staff was scared. At the end of the day, you're human. And we understand that. But you have to get over the fear in order to get to what you want to do. Okay. No matter what you want to do, you have to get over the fear, guys. All right. Okay. So to start off with the first pillar, guys, we're going to talk about planning. All right. And what I want to do is I actually want to help you guys plan. All right. So right now we have about 45 days left till the end of this year. Not that much time. Okay. So we have to be realistic here. All right. I don't want to tell anyone that's going to start this business, be like, yeah, if you start today, you'll be a multimillionaire by 2023. No, that's false hopes, guys. I'm not some guru online. No, I come with life experience. Being a full-time entrepreneur is my third career, guys. Okay. And it's actually close to being my most favorite. My first favorite, I'm not going to lie to you guys. If you guys don't know my history, I was a first responder. I was a detective. I had a lot of fulfillment. And to this day, that was my dream job. That was my fulfillment. But I had to take care of my health, guys. I had to take care of my health. And I also had to take care of my family. So ultimately, when I was at my 9-to-5, it wasn't sustainable to be there. Okay. The way things were going, the hours I was putting in, and the cost of inflation, guys, look at the recession we're in right now. I'm not trying to scare anybody. I'm just being realistic. Everything is going up in price. So if you are currently working at your 9-to-5 and they aren't giving you a pay increase, or they're giving you a pay increase that doesn't compete with the inflation rate, which, by the way, last year, I mean, how many of you guys know how much inflation went? Go ahead and drop it in the comments. I want to see everybody's opinion to see if you know how much inflation, and you could do a percentage, went up this year since last year, guys. And some of these numbers might shock you, okay? Some of these numbers might shock you, guys, but like I said, this is an interactive live, guys. I want you to interact. Go ahead and drop it down in the comments how much you think inflation went up, okay? And I'm going to look at the comments. So you got one person said 50%. Now, it's not that bad, though. Okay, 8%, 7%, 65%, double digits, minimum. Yeah. Guys, so most people are going to say anywhere between 8 to 9%, okay? Realistically, it was around 12%. 12%, guys. Think about that. If you guys put $100 in your savings, okay, in the beginning of the year, all right, it's at $88. It actually, instead of it increasing in the bank, it went backwards. So what you have to do is you have to do something. You have to be assertive with actually taking the actions to increase the value of your money by making your money work for you, whether it's ATMs, whether it's real estate, whether it is crypto, whether it's any other type of investment that works for you. Ultimately, ATMs is not going to be for everybody. And I'm not here to sell you. That's not my job here. My job is just to educate you and to tell you from my life experience what has worked for me and what has worked for thousands of actual members in this group. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm actually going to do a share screen, guys, and I'm going to show you where you guys can actually find the free resources inside of this group so you guys can go ahead and plan, okay? What I like to do, okay, I actually like to walk you through exactly how I would plan if I was a rookie in the game, okay? So let me go ahead and log into the actual ATM Business for Beginners Facebook group, and then I'm going to go ahead and actually do a share screen with you guys. So just give me 1 second. Okay, so right now you guys should actually be seeing this share screen. I'm inside of the group, guys. Now, when you guys see the above screen right here, you guys should actually be seeing right below where you see the 47,000 members, I'm going to click on guides. So the reason why I'm clicking on the guides is because, one, you're going to find our mini course. Our mini course is going to educate you on all of the pillars regarding the ATM business, guys. As you guys can see right here, ATM business mini course, introduction to mini course, ATM business startup, ATM processing. If you don't know what ATM processing is, we're going to go into it in just a minute, but it is the network that basically facilitates your transactions between your ATM and your banking network. This is important stuff because this is how you get paid, guys. Prospecting locations, very importante, guys. Location, location, location. Every independent ATM deployer knows this. It doesn't matter if you have the bells and whistles on your ATM or if you know you have a shiny bow. If you don't have a great location, you're not going to make any money. So ultimately, everything relies on your location. And then sales and closing deals. Ultimately, I started off as an introvert, guys. So no one taught me how to speak. No one taught me how to sell. At the end of the day, everyone is selling. Okay. Think about whenever you go to the doctors, they are selling you on different new medication. Okay. When you're going to the eye doctor, they are selling you on new lenses, new appointments, new glasses. Whenever you go to the mechanic, how many times you guys go to the mechanic and a mechanic's like, well, you should really do preventative maintenance, right? Even if you're a car person and you know exactly what you're going in there for, they're still going to try to upsell you, guys. In life, everything is a sell. Even if you are educating somebody, you are still selling, okay? Because it is your belief. You are influencing them, guys. So at the end of the day, if I was to tell you right now, this is coming from a 9-to-5er that generated multiple 7 figures in the past 3 years, okay, guys? I'm no one special, all right? I just invested in myself. That's all I did. I invested in myself approximately around 180K now. And I was able to 60X that, guys. That's all I did. It sounds simple, but it takes a lot of discipline because I'm going to tell you something right now. I'm not the most motivated person ever. I'm not. It takes somebody to keep me accountable. Okay. It takes like a get'em to keep me accountable. Sometimes it'd be like, hey bro, like, you know, get on your job, like get on your shit, dude. Come on. Like, there's a reason why you're running a multi-million dollar company. You need to execute on this and this and this. Hey, that's just being real, guys. We're humans. We're humans. We gas out. We get burnt out. That's just the way life is, okay? So sales is the number one skill set that I can recommend to any of you guys watching this right now. If you were to take anything away from this live, okay? Even if you don't go into ATMs, just remember, invest in self-education regarding sales. Just talking to people, the psychology behind it, marketing, prospecting, because it's going to help you in your niche. Even if you're in a 9-to-5, just every aspect of life, it does with sales, guys. So ultimately, just I'm telling you, that's my advice. That's my golden nugget from me to you. All right. So as we go down the guides section, guys, you're going to see a ton of actual real testimonials. These are testimonials that people literally book the week before we actually post them. They'll book it themselves or they'll post it themselves inside of the group, but we'll repost it and we'll actually explain their background. And the cool thing about this, I like to be very transparent when it comes to the testimonials, guys. I'm telling you, is we actually tag every single client that we post on here. Okay. So you can see right here, guys, we've been doing this. We've had the group for a little bit over 2 years now, but we've been posting it consistently for a year and a half. Okay. Cause you know, it's logistics. It's a lot of logistics, guys. We have about 20 employees now. So it takes a lot of infrastructure to do what we do. So 229 testimonials. We have the most recent ones on there, guys. And what I like is if I was new, okay, I would love to see someone who has the same background as me, because ultimately not everybody comes from the same background, right? So if I was a first responder, I would want to see if there was another first responder that was able to do this business. If I was in the military, I would love to see if there was a military member that was able to do this business. Same thing with real estate, same thing with investing, same thing with being a doctor, same thing with being a judge. We have so many clients in different niches and industries that have done this business and have been successful, guys. So I highly recommend, if you're watching this right now, when you do have a little time later on, you and your spouse or your family member, you guys can actually sit down and look through all these successful stories. And here's the great part about this, guys. You guys can actually message them and ask them, how's their experience? How did it go for them? Was it easy? Was it difficult? What didn't they like about it? All that jazz. You know, it's social proof, guys. It's great. Now, if you like to watch videos like YouTube or whatnot, I would highly recommend that you guys check out the weekly live recordings. The reason why is because we have over 75 recordings on here, guys, that we have different lessons everywhere from anywhere from credit repair to prospecting to marketing to sales to have to different ATM offers to logistics to ATM safety to processing. We have different live guests. We have different offers on there. So this will get your creative mind flowing. The reason why I like to watch videos, okay, or I like to learn from people more successful than me, because it makes you think differently, guys, okay? Just imagine if you grew up like I did with a bunch of friends, good friends, of course, but a bunch of friends that all thought the same, just because we weren't exposed to everything else. We weren't exposed to the big world out there, guys. So when it comes down to it, you guys are actually very lucky being in this group, because we expose you to people that have successfully launched their businesses, that have successfully landed 80 Dunkin' Donut contracts, that have successfully landed multiple hundreds or even thousands of ATMs, and then credit repair experts, multimillionaires in networking, digital marketing, all that jazz. I don't know any other space online where you can actually see this for free, guys. I know people in digital marketing, they're actually charging about $200 for access to stuff that we provide here for free. And I believe that that is the strongest, I guess you could say, where we come in strong as a company, that we provide so much value and we put our heart and our soul and our blood and tears into this just to provide so much value to the clients, that the clients, they just love it. Any digital marketer is watching this right now. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. So ultimately, this is why ATM Together has been able to get decent success in the past 2 years. Okay. And finally, guys, if you guys need some motivational group post, okay, we're talking about, these are stories from my personal experience, from our team members' personal experience. As you can see right here, here are the titles: Homeless Real Estate Investor to Over 50K with ATMs. That's Mike Sandon's story, remarkable story. I mean, almost made me shed a tear when I read it. But ultimately, yeah, it's powerful stories like that that will make you think and be like, wow, if that person can do it, why can't I? So it all comes from here. It all comes from mindset, guys. So the biggest thing, the biggest takeaway that I could tell you right here is, number one, if you're going to invest in yourself with educating yourself, do try to find a program that will teach you sales. Okay, that's number one. Or two, find somebody more successful than you in the niche that you want. So if you want to do ATMs, guys, we have the staff and the social proof that's going to back what we say, the results that you want. And ultimately, we have the mentorship that can help you succeed from A to Z. And then number two, it's all about mindset, guys. Ultimately, all of this, everything that I'm talking about, everything that I've ever shown online, it comes to your mind. You have to be positive with everything that you do, because once you go into any situation, okay, and I also learned this as a first responder, once you go into any situation negative, you've already lost. You have already lost. Think about that, okay? Think about any situation where it was a bad outcome for you. If you would have gone into that situation with a positive mindset, would things have been different? Yeah. That's what I always think to myself, guys. stay neutral, stay positive, and think. All right, guys. So make sure you guys plan. 45 days left. I know we have Getem. He's going to have two more sections. It's going to be quick. I know I took a little bit too long, Getem, but we'll make this quick, and then we'll get Kurt online to go ahead and interview him.
Let's make it happen. Let's make it happen. That was a phenomenal presentation, Paul. I mean, like, I'm all about keeping it simple, guys, but making sure you understand the resources you have available to you. Because I hear it all the time, right? When it comes down to the LLC, when it comes down to the bank, when it comes down to anything in the ATM business, you'll hear the same questions over and over. And it's okay to be brand new. It's okay to ask for help, but you gotta know where the resources are and take action to find those. Paul just broke it down for you, right? So the next resource you guys are gonna have is actually how to form your business when it comes to the ATM business. And when I say that, I mean the actual business entity. So if you're excited, like literally right now, this was your question. You're like, hey, you know, I had everything else. It doesn't matter if you had an ATM already, you had a location, but you're like, man, I just need to know the technicalities of the business formation. I'm about to give you some CPA attorney type advice right now. So comment LLC below. I want to make sure you're excited, guys, because at the end of the day, we get this question all the time. That's why I want to cover it. I want to make sure as many people know as possible. Don't be selfish, guys. It's okay. There's enough locations out there for everybody. Okay. Comment LLC below. Okay, so breaking down the actual ATM business. When it comes down to the business, you want to have a business entity. And the reason is because at the end of the day, it's considered high risk. How many of you guys have seen Ozark? How many of you guys have seen Sicario? I mean, that was a really good movie. But think about it, guys. Money laundering. That's the biggest concern in the business when it comes to the bank, when it comes to the processor, when it comes to anything, okay? So you want to do things by the book. You want to make sure you're official. You want to make sure you're professional, and you want to make sure your stuff is tight. So when you're making your LLC, you want to make sure it's appropriate also, because I've seen this all the time. There were these quote unquote gurus back in the day. They would tell people, hey, don't worry about it. Put the business in your own name, put it in your personal checking account. Just don't tell anybody. How many times have you heard somebody say, don't tell anybody, and it ends up the right way? I'll tell you right now, after years in law enforcement, that never ends up the right way. How many of you guys have seen First 48? Exactly, right? That's a little extreme, but come on, guys. It never works out right. So when it comes down to the LLC, the main reason why is because you want to form an entity to protect yourself. Keep the ATM business separate from all the assets you love. Whether it's sports cars, whether it's your home, whether it's your family retirement fund. Keep the business separate, because think about it. Imagine you had a taco truck and somebody trips and falls on a freaking piece of meat. Everyone loves a sue nowadays. That's just the US. It's sad, but that's the reality. So you always want to structure everything different. Like, imagine it like different turtle shells, okay? So when it comes down to the ATM business, we always say LLC to keep it simple. I'm a firm believer in simplicity sells and simplicity scales, guys. So keep it simple. There's no need to overcomplicate things. You can always transition to different entity types if you like. So what you need to form right now, there's only a few things, okay? Write this down. If you're thinking about forming your LLC for the business, if you're even contemplating the business, write this down, because I guarantee you, you're going to ask for it later. So you want to know where you're going to file. What I mean by that is you either use a third-party filing service, which is what we recommend, or you do the actual paperwork. Right? I'm old school. I like to write things down, but when it comes down to business paperwork, I like to actually do it myself. Okay. So with that being said, we always recommend Inkfile, which is INCFILE.com. Inkfile, we're not associated with them, but because they're so simple to form, we always recommend people use that. Okay. Then you also want to know who's going to be part of your LLC, whether it's going to be your brother, your sister, your mom, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, whatever, whether it's your dog, right? Because I mean, I would have my dog on the LLC. Well, you want to make sure their information is listed, because you're going to need it when you file, okay? You need their information. You want to know where your business is going to be at. Make a choice, okay? And I'm going to go through this quick, because Kurt is waiting right now. I see him waiting for us. So you want to make sure you know exactly where your business is going to be. We always recommend just do your home address nowadays, but you can always do a virtual business address, or you can actually have an actual office space. If you want more information on that, comment below. One of our team members will reach out and they'll point you out to the video that I have that covers that. Okay. Then you want to know what type of structure it's going to be. Or is it going to be member managed? Is it going to be manager managed? All that means is, are you guys going to be all equal? You guys equally make decisions, or are you going to have someone specific manage the business? Just make that decision. And then, of course, you want to know the NAICS code. All that is a classification code. The bank's going to ask for it. So you want to make sure this is accurate, because I'm going to get to the bank next. And I can't tell you guys, this is extremely important in California, in New York, in Florida. Things are changing. You need to write this down. So the NAICS code for the ATM business is 522-320. I'm going to say that one more time. 522-320. Write that down, guys. You can even sell that to somebody. Somebody will probably pay you $50 to find out what that is. It's important, guys. Most people actually didn't even know what that means. But write that down. That's the code you need to file and classify your business, because the bank is actually going to ask for it also. And sometimes they don't know, guys. All right. So that is a quick recap of the LLC. But now we got to move on to the bank. Okay. So the bank in the ATM business, Matt, let me just lean back. I can't tell you how many calls I've been on with clients, with people on introductory calls with us in the past, that the number one roadblock has been the bank. I cannot find a bank that works with me. Keep this in mind, guys. We had a client, a VP, vice president of a major bank. They had their bank shut down. It is extremely serious in 2022, going on to 2023. We warned about this in January. People didn't listen. Now people are running back and asking us. It's extremely important to find a bank that works with you, guys, because they're becoming very scarce now. So the reason you need a bank is because you need somewhere to receive your profits. And when you start profiting more, which is going to happen, guess what? You want it documented so you get lines of credits. So you can also get credit cards. You can get loans. You can get assets in your business's name. You get a reputation. So you want to start fresh. You want to start the foundation right with an actual business checking account. And of course, if you're working with a good processing company, they're going to require you to have a business checking account. If they don't, I don't know what to tell you guys. Right? I actually just came back from Chase today, right? Nothing against them. I love Chase. They work for my other businesses. I opened another business account today, unrelated to the ATM business, but they asked me for all these documents. And this goes into the lesson, guys. Have the documents you need. They asked me for two forms of ID, articles of incorporation, EIN letter, tax paperwork. And I said, wait, hold on one second. Just like, when you're a DJ and it skirts, you're like tax paperwork. And the banker's like, yeah, we need your tax paperwork. I was like, hey, but I just formed my business, which is going to be the position most of you guys watching this live are going to be in. He's like, yeah, but the banker, the manager, he says, I need your tax paperwork. I had to educate him. I always say that term, educate him. I had to educate him a little bit. I was like, hey, well, let me ask you this. If I just started a business a month ago, how would I have tax paperwork? And the look on his face was just like, you're right, get him. I don't know. He's like, but there's this checkbox we have to fill out. So I had to talk all the way to the manager. I was like, call the manager over. I was that person. I was like, hold on the line. Call the manager over. It's a new business. How am I going to have taxes? This goes into your business checking account, guys. You have to know what you're talking about. Remember, bankers are humans. They're just employees of that bank. You can't blame them if they don't know. But you need to know, because at the end of the day, it's not shame on them. It's shame on you, because you're the one opening the business. You are the subject matter expert in the industry. That's why you're providing a service, which is ATMs. So you need to know what you're talking about. And when you know what you're talking about, that means you have the proper paperwork, which is the LLC paperwork, the EIN letter, et cetera. You want to understand the type of account and why you're opening it. Be confident when you go there. Guys, back in the Marine Corps, you know what they used to say? Lean back and strut. What they mean by that was roll your shoulders back and go in there like you own the bank, because you will. Based on the profits you're going to have, you're going to own that bank. Realistically, you do own your own bank, which is an ATM, just like Paul says, infinity banking. Okay. But then you want to know what type of bank to go after. So real simple, guys, I'm going to keep this quick. Go after small banks or local credit unions or local smaller banks. The reason being is they're going to be more flexible. They're not stuck with a corporate structure where they have to get requirements and approvals from this person and that person. Then they got to go to the janitor to make sure the janitor can go up. No, keep it simple. I like to keep it with small, nimble banks and build a relationship with them, and they'll grow with you. Okay. They're more than likely going to approve your accounts. And then, of course, you want to know what to say, guys. Now, I had 56 messages the last live. when I told this line. I didn't know it was gonna be so popular, right? This is literally backed by popular demand. So if you wanna know exactly what it is to say to open your business checking account, or when you're trying to find a bank that works with you, to literally cut down on hours of calls, comment bank below, B-A-N-K, because at the end of the day, I know you're gonna open your business and I wanna help you out, guys. I don't see any comments. Let me see what we got here. Okay, a few comments, all right? When you're calling these banks, guys, I'm going to save it. Write this down, right? Write this down. You're going to call them. And this is like, you know, I'm from the 90s, right? We actually had phones that were like this, if you remember. But you're going to say, hey, my name is so-and-so. I'm calling to open a business checking account for my ATM business, right? And they're going to ask you, they might ask you some clarifying questions, like what's the ATM business? And you just let them know, hey, I'm looking to actually collect commission from my ATM business. That's it. Keep it simple. If there is a maybe, or if there's a yes, go to that bank as soon as possible. You know why? Because they can change their policy. More people may find out, and then what? Go to that bank, let them know you have an ATM business. You're looking to collect commissions from that ATM business. That's what that business checking account is going to be for. That's it. And I guarantee you, your process will be much smoother, guys. And then, of course, you want to go on into finding your ATM and your processor. Well, Paul's going to cover that because, like I said, we're running out of time and I want Paul to get on this.
Yeah, absolutely. So great overview on the actual LLC and the bank, get them. All right, guys. So to make it quick, just because we have to go and I know we have Kurt waiting, so I'm going to knock this out within the next couple minutes. So make sure you guys take notes, okay? Two things that you guys want to actually make sure that you execute properly when you have your own ATM business and you are actually vetting any ATM processing, any ATM supplier company, okay? Number one is you want to make sure that they give you 100%. Yes, you heard it right. 100% of your actual surcharge profits, okay? There's a ton of companies out there that will actually try to charge you a percentage on top of charging you a percentage per transaction, okay? They're going to try to have you sign a service agreement. Make sure that this does not happen. The reason why I'm telling you this is because it's happened to me, all right? I tell you from personal experience, so use my pain to not have any pain yourself. I paid $7,000 to get out of a 2-year contract, guys. Well, it was 3 years, but I used 1 year. So the remaining 2 years, they wanted $7,000 for me to get out of the service agreement to just stop using their processing. Now, for all my rookies, everybody that's absolutely green, if you don't know what processing is and you don't know how ATMs work, I mean, obviously, yeah, you take out money, you make money from it, but where's the cash come from? We get these questions all the time, guys. So the cash actually comes from you. You're probably like, Paul, I don't have that much cash in the bank. How much cash do you need to actually put inside the ATM? Good question. So you need about $2,000 to $3,000 to start. From there, you guys can scale. These ATMs hold up to $20,000, guys. Okay. So depending on basically your strategy on how passive you want this business to be, you can actually load these ATMs with as much as you want. That means it's a less requirement for you to actually go to the location to refill it. Okay. So with that, you want to make sure that you actually deal with a processing company that has your back. And what do I mean by that? I mean that they actually provide great customer service, because that's what it comes down to. Majority of these companies offer the same thing, except for us. And I'm not, it's funny how I said it. The only reason why I say that, guys, is because we're the only company out there that actually provides locations with our packages. So we're like a one-stop shop. If you just want to deal with one person, one team, you like the vibe, you like the way we're squared away and we handle business, then ultimately, you know, hey, we're here. We're here for you, right? But there are a lot of companies out there where you can get everything separate, but you're dealing with multiple people. And then also every client that we have, right? We have a membership pricing for them, which I'll tell you guys in a little bit after the interview. But with that, you want to make sure that you are not getting charged for this processing. Okay. So the processing, the way it works is it is basically the network that facilitates the transactions between your ATM, which I like to call your little employee, and your bank account, and then also the banking network. So anytime that somebody goes to your ATM and withdraws, let's say about $40 to $60, which is the average in the United States, ultimately you could charge them $3, $4, $5 sometimes. We were just in Miami and we went and we stopped by in Fountain Blue. They were charging $5 to withdraw cash. And guess what? I needed cash. I needed to tip the bartenders, the waitresses. They don't accept debit cards. They don't accept credit cards for tips, guys. They have a minimum on there, right? So when you really think about it, you're like, who uses cash? A lot of people. We actually just got a comment from a banker on our TikTok that was like, yeah, cash is still king, because just this past Saturday, I had over $400,000 withdrawn in cash, not from a single person, from multiple clients, guys, that are withdrawing cash to actually use it. Okay. So cash ain't going nowhere for a long time, not in our lifetime, guys. All right. So also think about this. Okay. When you put that $2,000 to $3,000 inside of the ATM and they withdraw that cash, once your ATM runs empty, all that's going to happen with the processing network that you're using is they're going to deduct it from every single client that deducted money from your ATM. And then the very next business day, it shows up on your business checking account. So then when your ATM runs empty, you could go and just refill your ATM with the exact same money. I like to call it infinity banking, guys. Okay. So my last 2 points, guys, is number one, 100% of your surcharge profits. Don't ever, ever let anyone take a percentage of your profits, please. Okay. And then two, do not sign a service agreement. And that's all. That's all I got for you guys. Okay. So let's go ahead with this interview. I'm going to go ahead and do the intro real quick. Get them. You there?
I think, yep, I'm here.
Okay. Awesome. All right, guys. So we are going to be interviewing a real estate investor. His name is Kurt Davis. He makes roughly around four figures monthly from ATMs. He has been a client for the past 18 months since we started this group. So Kurt Davis, he's a longtime real estate investor with sales in the multi-millions in his industry, guys. This guy is the real deal when it comes to real estate. So make sure to ask him questions. If you're a real estate agent, real estate investor, want to be an ATM independent deployer, then this is your man that you want to ask. He's been killing the game. He's actually one of the first clients that has actually been very creative, and he's actually gone and used Facebook ads to actually drive traffic for his client acquisition. Basically, he runs Facebook ads, creates the funnel, and then he lands locations. He lands merchants and sells them on his program. So it's remarkable. He's doing big things, and I love it. I love talking to Kurt. This is not going to be the first time. This is not going to be the last. So is Kurt there?
I am here.
What's up, buddy? How are you doing today?
Good, man. It's fantastic. Can you hear me?
Oh, I can hear you.
Awesome. Awesome. I appreciate you guys having me on again.
No, absolutely, sure, man. It's a pleasure. And thank you. Thank you for actually coming on. I know you're going to have great things to say about your business, but this is basically like an update, right? To see how everything's going. How's everything going with your Facebook ads and all that jazz. So let's go ahead and get started with the questions, Kurt. All right. So Kurt, for the audience that's watching right now, can you please tell them what you do for a living and where you're from?
So I'm originally from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, where I used to be a professional chef working in hotels for probably the better part of 10 or 11 years before moving to Memphis, Tennessee to completely switch focus and become a real estate investor. I actually had a friend who was living here in Memphis at the time, and it's one of those kind of, it's like, if I ever wrote a book someday, it'd be a great story. It's the typical story where I had a successful friend and he gave me an opportunity and I took it. And the last, I don't know, 15, 16 years have been incredible. So basically what I do, it's kind of like you watch those shows, flip this house. Basically I buy houses cheap, I fix them up and I resell them to real estate investors all over the country.
Yeah. You make it sound simple, but I know it's not that simple, right? Otherwise, everyone would be doing it.
Exactly. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it.
Exactly. Exactly. Nice.
I love that saying, man. You're staying very humble, especially about your craft. It's a very tough profession, but you're making it happen, man. I love it.
Absolutely.
So Kurt, let me ask you, why ATMs?
Oh, it's funny because it was roughly 2 years ago, right around this time is when I kind of started to get that itch about exploring ATMs a little bit more. I always had this concept that to buy an ATM machine was some ridiculous amount of money. Like I thought that these things were so expensive but once I started to do just a little bit of online research and looking into them, I found that they weren't really that far out of reach. So then I remember I kept trying to connect with people on Facebook before I connected with Mike and ultimately getting steered with you guys. I was having calls with people and just, I was trying to learn as much as I could, watching YouTube videos and ultimately until one time I connected with Mike on Facebook and he was gracious enough to talk to me one night because Mike is so busy, you can't get him on the phone right now. But somehow I was able to get probably like a solid hour of his time and he answered all my questions that I had. And really kind of from there, it was history. I just did what I needed to do to get going.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I mean, I remember when Mike hit me up and he was just like, hey, dude, like, so I talked to this real estate investor. His name is Kurt. He's in the group. Really great guy. We talked for like an hour or two and I was like, really? And he had told me you were like interested in it. I was just like, huh? And I think you were actually one of the first real estate investors that was really interested into ATMs. And then after you, man, I don't know if it was like I don't know if you told somebody through the grapevine and we got like literally a flow of investors, like real estate investors and real estate agents that just came through and they were just like, yeah, we're trying to do this too. So
for me anyways, just the clients that I work with and cater to in real estate, there are many reasons why my clients buy investment real estate. But one of the big main reasons in general is monthly cash flow. So yeah. You see my creeper behind me?
Yeah.
Bro.
He's like, what's up?
Why?
I know. So everybody's looking for monthly cash flow. So when I looked at the ATM machine business to, you know, if you just do the financial calculation based on if it costs this much to get started and you make this much in net monthly cash flow, the amount of money that, now keep in mind, for all the people out there who do know a little bit about real estate investing and taxes and why people buy property, if you were to only look at just the monthly cash flow, nothing else, not the depreciation and the tax benefits and all that stuff, if you strictly looked at just cash flow, the amount of cash flow that you can make, if you find a pretty, even just an average decent location, not like a home run, you know, that's doing like 400 transactions a month, but like if you find an average location, the amount of cash flow that you can net from just one location is equivalent to what investors are trying to achieve from, you know, buying a rental property. And the thing that I always like to hit home is that if I sold a house to an investor for $100,000, they're going to have to put at least, you know, 20% down, so $20,000, and they're going to have to fork over another $5,000 or $6,000 for closing costs and things like that. So they're $26,000 out of pocket to make that, let's call it $250 a month in net cash flow. But with ATMs, it was kind of like, this makes so much sense. It's like, I think I calculated at one time that an average return should be around 67% cash flow based on what it costs to, you know, get your operating expenses and everything like that. So to me, it just made so much sense to do this as an additional side business.
Yeah, absolutely. So perfect intro to the next question, my man. All right. So break down basically your ROI on your ATM route. Basically, the way we could do it is to simplify it just for the audience.
Yeah.
How many number of locations you currently have.
Okay.
And then how long did it take you to basically pay off your initial ATM? Because I know now, basically, your locations are buying you a new ATM and so on and so on.
That's correct.
Yeah. So go ahead and explain that to the audience, man. You're pretty good with the numbers, so I'm gonna let you have it.
So I will tell you that I am nowhere near where I should be for me, anyways. As long as I've been doing this, right now I have 6 active locations, but you know, sadly, I've got 4 machines on standby because I'm a believer in that when I do secure new locations, that I don't want them to have to wait 3 to 4 weeks for me to order a machine. I don't think that looks good. So yeah. I do have more locations ready to go once I do secure them. But to keep the number simple, with the 6 locations that I currently have, obviously with some of them doing really well and some of them not necessarily performing where I would like to be, and the majority of them in the middle, I think I net, after paying the location and my expenses and that kind of stuff, I'm netting somewhere around $1,200. And my time involved in that is very minimal. I maybe stock my machines a little more than maybe some people need to, but that's just because I personally do not want to have to go to machine. I have it set up to where I hit my machines around every 7 or 8 days. I'm kind of making the rounds. My tattoo location keeps me busy. I mean, I think that thing goes through around $8,000 to $9,000 a week. Wow. And to kind of also touch on, when I bought my first machine, I would say I purchased another one shortly after that. But once I got my first 2 locations going very, very solid, I was able to save up enough money with my profits to then funnel that into purchasing new locations. So I'm at a point now where, like I said, it doesn't sound like a lot. I'm not jumping up and down to high five about the 6 active locations, but the point is that these locations now are funding additional, like they will fund more. So if I needed to buy another machine right now, I could go out and buy another 2, 3, 4 machines right now with what I have saved up. So even if I did that and it drained my account very low, with the amount of net cash flow that I have coming in, within 2 months, I'll be able to buy another machine. But if I'm funding those locations with, if I have all my machines out, I could probably buy a brand new machine every single month. So, you know, I'm fortunate enough to be in a position to where if I have to buy more machines, I could. I've got my, you know, I do not have to use a vaulter for my location. So I'm very fortunate to be able to maximize 100% of my own profit. But I am not nowhere near where I want to be, but I can see the vision. I can see where I need to get to and where I will be.
Yeah, absolutely. And just let me break it down to the audience real quick, just because I know there was some ATM jargon on there, Kurt.
Yeah, sorry.
So guys, vaulting. Okay, so vaulting, what that is, that's a third-party system that basically will fill your ATM and then you give them a percentage of your surcharge fee. Okay, so let's say your surcharge fee is around $3. You're going to give them around $1. Okay, you're going to give them $1. Then you go into a vaulting agreement with the vaulter, which is usually another independent ATM deployer, just like yourself. And ultimately, they will fill your ATM with their money. And then there's usually a little clause on there where they'll take care of the maintenance, since they're going to go and fill the ATM anyways, right? And these ATMs, they don't require a lot of maintenance, guys. When they break down, it's going to be once in a blue moon, or if a kid decides to stick a toothpick in the card reader. But other than that, there's nothing major that breaks down, guys. And these ATMs, they come with 2-year warranty. So it's remarkable, okay? So if you're not tech savvy, you don't got to worry about that. Now, to go back to what Kurt was saying, what I love about Kurt's journey in the ATM industry, one, he came from real estate investment, guys. So for all my real estate investors, real estate agents, who here that is watching right now actually owns real estate, okay? Or has invested in real estate in the past, go ahead and comment all in. That's going to be ALLIN. Go ahead and comment all in if you've ever invested in real estate, own real estate, or you're currently a real estate investor or real estate agent. We just want to know who you are. Okay. This is an interactive live, guys. So go ahead and help us out with the algorithm so we can provide this group to more people on Facebook. Okay. Now, what's remarkable about what Kurt said is that his ATMs currently right now, his 6 active ATMs, can buy them a brand new ATM every 2 months. Okay. Now, when you break it down within 12 months, that's approximately six ATMs per year brand new that he's not paying out of pocket, guys. That is called cash flow. That is remarkable. A ton of people want to do that. And ultimately, Kurt's doing it like I did it. My first year, I didn't take any profit. All I did was keep reinvesting the money inside the business and just have it grow like a money tree, guys, because that's ultimately what it is. You're here to build generational wealth. You're not here for instant gratification to be an instant millionaire. No, I always tell people that ATMs, unless you're building volume, it's not going to get you instantly rich. It's really not. So don't go on a hope and a prayer that your first ATM is going to make you $1,000, because the highly likely chance of that happening, it's very minimal, but it does happen, guys. There's locations like Dante Mersaw, $2,000 in a nightclub, right? And now the kid's, you know, driving his dream car and he's able to take care of his baby girl. And that's not the only location he has, but ultimately there are clients that have locations like that. Okay. So this is as real as it gets. And this is why we wanted to do the interview with Kurt, because he keeps it real and we like that.
I'll tell you, I posted, I think a couple months ago, it was in September. I did my first, outdoor event, a festival. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, that was a lot of fun. That it was just exciting. It was fun. I had the machines, you know. Of course, I went out and spent a little bit of money getting tents and signs and making sure everything was good. You know, the big key about that, though, that, you know, people need to think about is that, you know, you have to have a lot of cash. You know, I had to go to the bank and give them like a notice, like a week in advance on how much that I was going to need to come to get. And it was ridiculous walking out of the bank with that much money in 20s.
Yeah.
So, but it was a lot of fun. I think I posted that, you know, if it wouldn't have rained half the day on that Saturday, I would have cleared a lot more, but I think I made somewhere around, again, it's not jumping up and down numbers, but, you know, I think I made close to $1,200 to $1,500 in that, let's just really call it a day and a half.
Yeah.
And that isn't in that 2 day event is essentially what I make in 1 month with just my regular machines. So it was nice to, that's another thing that people could get into if they can kind of break into that, if you want to kind of call it festival outdoor event type of, you know, ATM business. I thought it was fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, those outdoor activities, mobile ATMs, basically what we call it in the ATM world. Mm-hmm. If any of you guys are actually looking to get educated on that, a really, really educated guy on mobile ATMs, one of our clients, David Linares. Get him. If you could go ahead and tag David Linares in the comments. If you guys want to reach out to David Linares, go ahead and comment David down below, and then I'll reach out to him after this live, guys, and he can reach out to you guys regarding mobile ATMs. But I do want to talk to Kurt about his specialty in the ATM industry, which I think is remarkable. I don't even do this with my ATM locations or my tangible ATM business. I do it with ATM together. Facebook ads. Let's go ahead and talk about that, Kurt. I see that smile on your face, buddy. All right. So with Facebook ads, how did you figure out Facebook ads?
I, like a lot of things as a, you know, a business owner, it's, you will make it a lot further if you surround yourself with people who have a specialty or experience in something else. So I surround myself with people who are in marketing and things and whatnot. So I have a buddy of mine named Jack, who is very savvy in the social media, type of environment. He knows how to create Facebook ads and whatnot. So he and I got together and I told him what I wanted to do, because there's, at the end of the day, if we don't have locations, we're out of business. Doesn't matter how many machines we own or how much money we have. If we don't have locations, we don't have a business. So there's lots of different ways that people can acquire locations. You can, you know, it's there. I mean, I won't get into it, but there's a lot of different ways. And one of the ways that I wanted to do, because in real estate, you know, we're looking for buyers, we're looking for sellers. So we do multiple different types of advertising across multiple platforms. So we thought, Facebook being one of the top ones, let's try Facebook advertising. So we created a very simple ad to essentially generate leads. And like anything, how much money do you want to spend per day, per month, per campaign, whatever it is. So when we first rolled out our first ad, I want to say within the first 30 days, I think I secured two locations at that time. And I think my ad spend was somewhere around a little less than $400 that particular month. So once we had that going on, I slowed down a little bit on the advertising, just because that I ran out. I used up the machine that I had waiting in the wings, and I had to hurry up and get with my processor so we could order some more machines. But it's one of those things where if I want some more locations, which I technically do, I need more locations, all I have to do is turn back on that marketing and put whatever I want as my budget. And I've already got the ad in place. So, you know, that was something that I think last time when I was on, you were gracious enough to let me give a small shameless plug for a program that my partner and I put together, which ultimately it's a one-time fee, and it's a step-by-step follow along instruction that teaches you how to create your own Facebook ad and generate leads, unlimited leads for your location or wherever you're trying to put machines. And in the target is, obviously we're targeting business owners or Facebook managers of these businesses that we're trying to target. And it's really a system that works, but you know, like anything, it's going to cost a little bit of money to, you know, essentially get the program. Plus, you know, once you get your Facebook ad set up, how it's like anything, the more money you pay, the more leads you're going to get coming in faster. The less money that you put in, it'll be a little bit slower. So, but ultimately at the end of the day, it works.
Yeah, guys. I mean, it's another great avenue to drive traffic to your guys's actual website. If you guys have a website or social media platform that where you're advertising your ATMs or your actual business and whatever business you guys are at, Facebook ads is where it's at. I was able to create a multi-million dollar business just off of Facebook before I even had a website. So I'm a big, big, big believer on what Kurt is saying as far as being around people that know more than you in a specific niche or expertise. Kudos to you, my man. Second, guys, I dropped a link down in the comments below. It's Udemy. That's going to be udemy.com. Very cheap courses where you can learn basically anything about digital marketing. Kurt, if you have the link, brother, at the very end of this interview, go ahead and drop it down below. And then we'll go ahead and just reach out to the audience real quick and let them know if they're interested. They could go ahead and click on that. Now, one thing that I do recommend, guys, is that if you are green or a complete beginner, like you don't even have your machine yet, then just be careful with actually going straight to Facebook ads before you know the basics. Learn the basics first, guys. I know we're all eager beavers. I know we're all eager beavers. And trust me, I've always been like that, like squirrel, right? But you wanna go ahead and actually learn the basics. So I recommend doing a free actual informational call with our team and then seeing if our program's the right fit for you guys. And then after the fact, if we do have existing clients, because I know we have existing clients that watch this every week, go ahead and actually check out Kurt's course on the actual Facebook ads. It's really good. And hey, you'll learn something new, right? I know Christmas break is coming up. Everybody got that 2 weeks. So hey, let's self-invest in ourselves, especially because that's the one thing I was talking about in the beginning. Self-education is everything. So cool.
Exactly. Yeah. And then Kurt, I actually want to get in here. So, I mean, obviously the audience knows you're an expert. You're considered an expert in the real estate niche and in ATMs. So knowing what you know now in hindsight, if someone was to only have, let's say $10,000 invest, mm-hmm. start a business, what would you choose, real estate or ATMs?
I would choose ATMs. And the reason why I say that is real. I know that there's a lot of people out there that, you know, talk about, you know, I can take $10,000 and turn it into $1 million. I mean, sure, there are people that do that, but realistically and being practical, $10,000 in the ATM business will take you so much further. You will have a higher return on investment. It's easier to get started. You're not having to qualify with a bank or you know, it's just a lot easier to get started. So Sadly, $10,000 is really not going to take me that far in the real estate investing world. So,
yeah,
I mean, if that's kind of someone's starting budget, and I know that for a lot of people, that's, you know, that's tough to put together, but that ATMs, that's where I'd start if I was starting with roughly 10 grand.
Yeah, exactly. So, and guys, just if you're listening, just to be clear, Kurt isn't saying like, hey, don't ever invest in real estate. It's just saying if you were starting off and that's about the amount you want a faster return on investment, ATMs is what he leans towards right now, but they complement each other, guys. That's what we always like to be clear about, because there's a lot of factors that go into investments. But if you want a cash flowing business that can potentially even fund your real estate purchase, I mean, nothing else makes a little more sense than ATMs.
Absolutely. But, it's interesting because I'm on the Facebook page a lot, and I see a lot of the new people starting, and everyone's got their questions. And I remember starting out too, having those same questions, nervous about installing my first ATM machine and things like that. But it's like after doing it, you install one ATM machine and the rest will be super easy. And plus the support and the network that you have from a community like this, everybody is so willing to answer questions that, I mean, I got the circus crew behind me, but it's just a whole lot. Everything's just, there's a lot of support and everybody's willing to help out. And that's what's really great about a community like this. Everybody asks questions, and regardless if it's the same question that we've seen 1,000 times, people are happy to answer.
For sure. And I appreciate the good words. I mean, it kind of leads into the next question. How do you like working with the ATMtogether.com team and Mike, who you actually briefly mentioned earlier, but he's our processing partner, guys, in case you're wondering.
Mike's the reason essentially why everything works for me, from helping me purchase my machines, my processing, some of the videos, some of the training videos that a lot of people have watched where we're programming Gen Mega 2500s and things like that. You know, we put those videos together, and it's, you know, so he's just such a dynamite person to work with, and just the whole community and working with the team. Your guys' location finding service is fantastic. Some of my better locations that I have come from, you know, when we've contracted together to get those.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. So, I mean, it's what I like. I actually have a final question for you.
Sure.
And it's perfect, right? Because obviously you have your children in the background, and this should tell you guys, it's not scripted.
Yeah.
So this is, we're real people. We love that in the background, because at the end of the day, when it comes down to the ATM business, we understand that it's real people getting involved, right? It's not just some Instagram gurus. It's, you know what I mean? It's actually real people, and that shows.
Yeah. So for people, I mean,
yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
No, go ahead. Yeah.
It's just, like I said, it's, you know, this is daily life. This is just kids, family, work, real estate, ATM. It's like you try to find this perfect balance and put it all together. And, you know, just the thing, like I said, what's so great about, you know, what we do here with ATMs, it's like I can monitor everything from my app or online. I can see when my machines are getting low, and I can plan ahead. And when I go out to the locations, I'm in and out real fast. So it's just super easy. Simple. And it's honestly, 2 years in, it's still exciting. I still get excited seeing the machines get used online. So, you know, I remember my wife in the beginning, at first she was just like, is this even worth it? You know, if you've only got a few machines, or, you know, is it worth it if you're only making $1,000 or whatever? But it's like, listen, the overhead is low. The business is growing, and it doesn't take up a lot of time. It's maybe a few hours a week at most.
Yep. That makes sense. So let me ask you this then, right?
Yeah.
For anyone in the audience, right, that might be in a similar situation, maybe with children, maybe they're working different jobs, they have other investments, they're busy, basically, they're living a busy life.
Yes.
What words of advice or encouragement would you have for them?
Don't, if you're that person and you're watching these videos, don't look at any of us as being so successful. Like none of us started out awesome in this business. Like we all started in the same place. So I can tell you that when I was looking around for this, there really is nobody else offering weekly training. There's nobody who has a pro, if you want to call it a turnkey system in place for people. And that's one of the biggest things is it's like everybody has a different personality. There's some people out there who are super self-motivated go-getters that just need a little bit of direction. And this program would maybe not be a good fit for them. But for, I would like to think that the majority or a higher percentage of people, they're busy. They're working their 9 to 5 or their overnight shift, and they've got lots of engagements and they don't have time to essentially do this themselves. So having a done for you system in place is really a game changer. And regardless of the cost of what it costs to get involved, it's, you know, people go to college, people spend thousands and thousands of dollars to go to motivational seminars just to sell more courses and books. But, and that's all great. I'm not talking negative about that, but like for this specific niche, I mean, they're actually, you guys are providing a valuable service that nobody else is providing. So if you're the new person who's looking at this, wondering if this is real or not, this is absolutely real. It works. The only question is, do you work?
For sure. Great, great, great words of advice. Really appreciate it. I mean, I know people in the audience appreciate it based on the comments, but if they need to find you, I know Paul mentioned the link. I don't know if you have it handy. Well, let's do this to make it actually simple, guys. If you guys want to get access to what Kurt offers, and it's talking about scaling locations, how to find them on your own, comment Kurt below. That way, Kurt on the back end will reach out to you guys. And if he doesn't get a chance to you, we will connect you guys. But comment Kurt, C-U-R-T, and he will get to you regarding exactly how you can launch your own ads too, guys.
In a worst case scenario, I'll get the link and I'll get it to you. Or if it's okay with you guys, I'll just do a one-time post on the page and make it accessible there if that's okay. I know that when I get off with you here, with you guys here, it's a kitty wrangling bedtime routine. So
WWE or WWF.
Oh right? Man, it's a process.
Yeah, no, for sure, man. Well, hey, thanks again for coming. I know it's late over there, so I really appreciate your time, the input you did today, all right?
I appreciate you guys having me on.
Sure.
Kurt, take care, brother.
Guys, see you later.
See you, buddy.
It's phenomenal.
Wow. Yeah, that was a great, great interview, man. So, all right, guys. So that went a little bit over the scheduled time that we had. So I'm just going to dive right into it. So we're going to dive right into how ATM automation will allow you to buy back your time, guys. And this is usually how I like to wrap up these lessons. It's basically just showing you guys exactly why we are the number one experts in this industry when it comes to ATM automation. And we are the founding fathers of this exact system. So let's jump into it. I'm going to go ahead and do a share screen, guys, and it's going to take me no longer than 10 minutes, okay? I'm actually going to go ahead and try to time myself. Where's my timer? Oh, I can't find it. All right. It's all right. Let's go. All right. Awesome. So, guys, quick question for the audience that's currently watching right now. How do you guys value your time? Okay. Go ahead and comment time down in the comments below if you value your time. Time is everything. And I know you guys heard the expression, time is money. So in this case, when you guys are trying to build the infrastructure, you guys are trying to build a business, a tangible business, not a digital business, tangible business. It's going to take some time. It's going to take some footwork. It's going to take some endurance. So go ahead and comment time right now if you want to build financial freedom today. It's going to be T-I-M-E down in the comments below. Help us out with the algorithm, guys. It really helps us grow this group. All right, guys. So here is going to be my explanation whether or not you would want expert help or you want to do this on your own, okay? So let's go on the breakdown of the actual ATM business. And you guys are going to love this because ultimately people ask, so what do I got to pay for? What is included? All that jazz. So startup costs for yourself. So this is if you were to do this business on your own, guys. Okay. So ATMs, they roughly run around $2,300 to $2,700, depending on what type of model you get. When you're new, you always want to go new. Okay. Do not buy used, please. I have literally spoken with hundreds of clients that have bought used, and either there's a malfunction with the ATM, they're not compatible with the new systems that are out right now, so they can't use them, or they need to buy so many parts for these used ATMs that it's not even worth it. Okay. So do yourself the favor. At most, you'll be able to find the ATMs at $2,300. Make sure to get bids from different ATM suppliers as well. Internet modem. Typically, internet modems are roughly around $150, and you'll have a monthly recurring fee of about $5.99, so about $6. With us ATM together, we usually charge this $5.99. Your first modem is included within our package, which I'll tell you in just a minute. But we give you the option of actually choosing between Verizon or AT&T, guys. It's pretty good, okay? So whatever works in your area. ATM processing. Now, if you were listening to us before, ATM processing is the network that facilitates your transaction between the actual ATM, the banking network, and your business checking account, guys. So it's very importante that you guys have this. Now, remember the two golden nuggets that I told you guys earlier. Make sure that you guys do not get charged a percentage of your surcharge profits. This is very important, okay? The second thing, make sure there's no monthly service agreement, meaning that they don't tie you down to them actually using them or tying you down to the company for the processing network where you cannot get out of it if something was to happen, okay? That's what happened to me. I paid $7,000 to get out of a remaining two-year contract, and it was no bueno, okay? Now, location. You guys are probably wondering, like, why do you have free on there with question marks? Well, we're going to talk about what is your time worth, right? And then we're going to talk about paying for services, okay? And this is the logic that I like to use now that I have been able to generate multiple seven figures in business. Me, myself, if you guys don't know my background, one, I was in law enforcement for the past 7 years. I was a serial entrepreneur for the past almost, I'm going to say like 20 years. So since I was like 14, from literally going and reselling video games at garage sales to generate money to go buy other things that I wanted to invest in, to being a nightclub promoter for 4 years, to investing in e-com, to getting scammed with other digital marketing services, about $30,000 in the past, guys. And then finally landing with ATM. So ultimately it was a ride, but it's worth it because all you need is that one opportunity in your life. Okay. And you've made it. You don't need several opportunities. No, you just need one opportunity. So ultimately, if you guys keep trying and trying and trying, ultimately you guys are going to learn from your failures. Okay. And ultimately that's what's going to make you successful in life. And that's what happened to me. I learned from my failures. So I went into different situations more intelligent. And as I invested my money, I already knew, okay, well, this makes sense. Okay, here's the return on investment. And just like what Kurt said, real estate investor that has sold multi-millions every single year in real estate investing and saying, I mean, you guys heard it from him, ATMs has a faster and better cash flow of return on investment than real estate, which is true because majority of people in the United States, one, we don't have time. And then two, hey, how many of us had $10,000 to invest? But I'm not saying to invest just like that, but invest where it hurts. And that's with me. All my investments, it hurt because I was like, oh, if I lose this, it's going to suck, right? Ultimately, you feel that pain because how many of you guys work that extra overtime or that extra shift or that second job, or you do the extra hours at the office or wherever you work to save that money to invest? I understand that because I've been there. Okay. So location is going to be free for right now and question mark, but I'm going to leave that in just a minute. Okay. Now, Vault Cash. Vault Cash is the cash that you're going to be using inside of the actual ATM, guys. And I want to make sure that I'm still live on here just because I saw my screen freeze. But okay, cool. So With that, the cash that you're going to use inside the ATM is about $2,000 to $3,000. Okay. $2,000 to $3,000 inside of your ATM. That's going to be your replenishment cash. That's going to be the cash that you're using over and over and over again inside of your ATM that your customers are going to withdraw, and you're going to make your cash make you more cash. Okay. That's why I like to call this infinity banking. Now, let's go back to the location. Location, location, location. Location is everything, guys. Now, when I used to be in law enforcement, okay, my overtime, okay, once I surpassed my 10-hour shift, I would go work an additional 5 to another 10 hours a day, guys. All right? And I'm telling you, this is pretty normal for a first responder, whether you're a doctor, a nurse, a police officer, a detective, paramedic, anybody in that industry, okay? That's the amount of hours they're working, okay? And if you're a first responder or you're in the medical field or any of those fields, firefighter, you know what I'm going to be talking about. So on overtime hourly rate, I was making around $80. What I like to call that overtime hourly rate, to be honest with you guys, it was blood money. That's it. Simple. I was losing sleep. It was unhealthy because I was drinking those Bang energy drinks or the rock stars that one time put me in the hospital. True story. I'll get into that later. No sleep, lack of personal relationships, just going down the toilet, guys, just absolutely everything. Okay. The worst of the worst for this blood money. So $80 hourly rate, you multiply that by the average, which is going to be about 40 to 100 hours to find a quality location, a decent location, okay? Just like Kurt was saying, you know, there's going to be locations that vary, guys. So there's going to be locations that are awesome. There's going to be locations that suck, and then you have to relocate the ATM. That's the great thing about the ATM. It is a floating asset. So it's an asset that you're buying just like real estate. But in real estate, right, you get a shitty tenant, guess what? You're going down for the ride. ATM, you put it in a bad location, then you can relocate it after 2 to 3 months and you'll be fine. That's what happened to me in the very beginning. I started with 6 ATMs. 3 out of the 6 did completely nothing, barely anything, like $50. And then I relocated those 3, which equaled my 6. And ultimately, I made $3,000 my third month. And that's what broke my limited beliefs. I was like, dude, I could scale this to the moon, right? So then when you do this calculation, for my example, the overtime of the $80 hourly rate with the 40 to 100 hours at a decent location, you get about $3,200 to $8,000. Realistically, full transparency here, guys, okay? I gave you the range just because everyone's different. There might be a sales guru right now watching this live that can sell literally everything. Right. And you may not even spend 40 hours to go out there and actually find a great location. Okay. You might be that lucky one that goes out there and boom, you got a golden goose. Right. But for the average person, I'm an average person. For the average person, it's realistically going to take 100 hours. Realistically, that's no BS transparency right there. Okay. Actually, cold calling, going in there, door knocking, building relationships, trying to close the deals, figuring it out, all that jazz. Okay. It's a process, guys. It's a second job. Okay. All right. So now that we got those numbers, so the true cost of a self startup with investment with money and time in this business, just like any business, this is an investment. This is a business. If you were to do this on your own, guys, it would roughly be about $6,450 to about almost $14,000. Even if you were to go find your own location, even if you were to go do everything on your own, even if you went and you bought a book to learn this system and you were to go ahead and learn it the hard way, which would take you more than 100 hours, it would probably take you about 400 to 500 hours, to be realistic. That's how long it took me. Shot myself in the foot and ultimately had to relocate the locations, had to pay thousands of dollars in a mentor in my second month. And not only that, but my pride went down the toilet, guys. I was prideful. You know, I came from law enforcement. And then also I was a sales manager before I was in law enforcement. So I felt really small when my locations didn't do well. But it is what it is. You learn as you grow, right? So to save you guys the headache, this is what we have created. This is what we have refined in the past 2 years. Currently have about 1,500 clients that have used our system, that love our system, just like successful actual clients like Kurt Davis, okay? So let's talk about our Automation Elite Package. Now, what this is expert help, basically, okay? Let's talk about the four pillars. The four pillars is included within your package. We're talking about the infrastructure. Just like Kurt said, this is not a course. This is an actual business. It's a tangible business. We're building the infrastructure for you. No one else does that on the online space, guys. That's why when I came up with it, people were like, you're going to do what? Yeah. So this is our mandatory package that every single member goes through, guys. One brand new ATM, the Hyosun Halo 2. What I would recommend if I was watching this right now, whether you're on your iPhone or your Android, go on your notes section right now or send yourself a text message and make sure you type that out correctly so you're able to go look at a photo of it after this live, okay? Comes with a 2-year warranty. Replace the parts, no out-of-pocket expenses off of that. You get one-on-one attention, guys, from our technicians that will help you. We have a dedicated customer service line for our clients. Actual real people that are in this industry that are able to help you, okay? You got to realize the value behind that, okay? People that have put their sweat, blood, and tears into this business that built a nice nest egg, and ultimately, they're going to provide you years of experience to help you become successful the first time. Not the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. No, the first time, guys. Okay. We shoot for you to be successful. All right. We don't take chances here. We want you to be successful. Number two, internet modem. We actually include that within your package. Now, we take care of the first monthly payment, which is $5.99. But after that, guys, it's $5.99. That's going to be your only recurring charge, guys. Yes, because I get that all the time. What is the overhead monthly on this? Your overhead monthly, it is your internet cost, okay? Because we recommend that you have a dedicated wireless internet for your ATM. Don't trust connecting it to a random stranger, even if it's the merchant or the business owner, okay? Unlimited processing network for unlimited ATMs. Two things on this, okay? Now, like I was saying earlier, guys, with this, the two golden nuggets that I said, number one, you're going to keep 100% of your profits, all right? And then number two, we're actually not going to sign you to a service agreement because we are so confident you're going to love the team, number one, and then you're going to love the service, that you're actually going to refer multiple people to us. And then two, you're going to be a recurring client because I'm going to tell you like this, this business is addicting. It's very addicting, okay? Because when you're making your money work for you, then something clicks in your mind and you're like, huh, dude, all those years of keeping like 10, 20, 30 grand in my bank and it wasn't making me shit. Damn, I wish I would have found this out years ago, just like I did. I found out about this 6 years ago, but I knew about it 10 years ago and I just didn't execute because I was comfortable, guys. I really was. That's just being real. All right. So back to a limited processing network. So those are the two things. We're not going to charge you for that service that comes free with the package and for unlimited ATMs as well, because we know you're going to come back as a recurring client and you're going to be able to get the ATMs at cost. Okay. And I'll get into that in just a little bit. The network that we use, it's called Switch Commerce. And then also one key takeaway that Kurt Davis actually mentioned during the interview, which I like, is that he mentioned the application on your phone. How cool is it that you can actually look at your phone and it tells you how much money you're making, guys? It puts a smile to everyone's face. You can see me like I naturally smile when I talk about it because it's awesome. I don't know what other business you can do that besides, let's say like Amazon, if you're into e-commerce, right? But this is a tangible business. You can feel this business. It's real. Real people are using it. You don't have to worry about a major corporation like Amazon shutting you down and then you losing literally tens of thousands of dollars like what happened to me a few years ago, okay? And then the very last pillar, one location included. And this is very important, guys. I'm going to harp on this. Now, we are the only company out there, the only resource that actually has a guarantee with the locations. And I'm going to explain this very thoroughly to you. The way this works is we actually have a call center that's going to facilitate the location for you, okay? We understand, going back to what I was talking about, and I'm just going to go back a little bit, to this formula, okay? It roughly takes about 40 to 100 hours, realistically more than 100 hours to find a decent location. You got to think to yourself, if you're currently working a 9-to-5 right now and you don't have 100 hours to spare because you have a family, you have kids, you have vacation, you have other responsibilities that you rather do than actually build another source of income, but you still want to do both, then more than likely, this is going to be the best option. It just makes sense. It's a no-brainer. Now, if you do have the time, then what I would recommend, okay, this is the route that I took. I took vacation time out of my 9-to-5 to build this business. I took 2 weeks off and I had told myself, I only have 2 weeks that I'm getting hit for at work to build a side income business. So I'm going to make this happen. And that's what I did. I sacrificed my own vacation time, sacrificed taking vacation with my family to build a business. But if you don't have the luxury, because vacation time is luxury, guys, trust me, I come from the same place. I still consider myself a 9-to-5er. Is the fact that if you don't have the vacation time to take to actually build your own business, I highly recommend that you look at this opportunity. It's phenomenal. Okay. So back to the location finder services. So you'll get assigned an actual sales associate. They will do all the work for you. They will negotiate the terms and conditions with the actual merchant of the location, no matter what state you are at. Okay. And then once they find the location and they have all the intimate details for you, they will contact you within 30 days of you actually having your appointment with them, guys. Again, 30 days from the time that you have your appointment. Okay. And I'm actually going to show you guys the guarantees while I speak about this. So when they do that, you as the business owner have the opportunity to go ahead and actually say, I don't like this location. You have the opportunity to go do a friendly follow-up and just meet the actual merchant and say, okay, well, this is the information you provided my sales team. What's the foot traffic? And if it's any different from what they told us, guess what? Don't take it. We'll find you another location, guys. It's remarkable. We're the only company that does this. We guarantee a location replacement based on performance base. So as long as you vet your location and you give us the green light and you're happy with it, okay, cool. Let's say COVID part 5 happens next year. Communicate with us, guys. Closed mouths don't get fed. Let us know, and then we'll go ahead and we'll work with you, okay? And trust me, I'm no stranger to hooking people up because I'm a good person. I want to work with good people. That's what I always tell people. I want to be around positive people. This is why we're extremely selective with who we work with, guys, as well. Okay. I'm just going to be very transparent with you. We're not here to deal with naysayers. We're not here to deal with negative-minded individuals. Come into this 100% ready to execute, too, with positivity, because that's all you're going to get from us is positivity, guys. You're going to get a team that has helped literally thousands upon thousands of entrepreneurs throughout the United States, and we've helped them build a tangible and sustainable business, okay? So let me go into the guarantees, guys. Number one, we're going to guarantee you a bank account approval, okay? Number two, we're going to guarantee you a location within 30 days of the bank account approval. Number three, guarantee location replacement based on performance. So if you're not happy with the location, let us know. We'll talk it over. And then we'll find you another location, guys. We don't have an issue. Just talk to us. And then number four, we have a guaranteed accountability manager. Now, it is actually three accountability managers, guys. We have a main one, which is Eileen, and then we have two, Ron and then Ro. They are legit. They will handle any issues you guys have, okay? So please, if any of our current clients is watching right now and you don't know who to ask, there you go. I just said it, your accountability manager. All right, so let's jump into it, guys. So you got to really ask yourself, guys, what do you want to do? Do you want to build your business with a team or you want to do it alone, okay? Ultimately, it's up to you. I'm not here to sell anyone. I'm not here to be Wolf of Wall Street and be like, yeah, you got to do it, you know, probability. No, it's not like that, guys. We're here to provide value and we have a service. It's a remarkable service. And if you want, we could definitely help you, okay? So we'll save you hundreds of hours, which in my eyes, okay? And I wish I could take a piece of my brain and give it to everyone watching right now, because I wish you can see what I see now. It's so much clearer when you have a system and you have a blueprint, guys. When you have vision and you're able to inspire literally hundreds of people, but including your team, and your team executes because of that reason, dude, your life is going to be so much different. Trust me. Okay. So here's my question to you guys. How do you guys value your time? That's realistically how you have to see this. It's about time, guys. The next 5 years is coming up. We're getting older. I'm about to be 35 in about 2 months or so. Okay. All right. So this is what I have for you guys. So unfortunately, appointments have been sold out for the past 4 weeks. Full transparency, guys. Like I said, we're not about selling you anything on this actual live. This is all value. But this is what I have for you, okay? I'm just going to give you a heads up on this. So we're going to be opening the informational calls. These are strictly informational calls where we do not try to sell anyone. It's just simply just to get more information based on what we can offer. And then they'll give you basically an ETA on when we can possibly enroll you as a client, okay? So the informational calls are going to start on November 21st. So that's going to be the same day that I do that special Instagram live with Kwani Bates, okay, from Razo Vending on Instagram, guys. So I highly recommend that you guys watch that IG. And then I'm going to be going ahead and dropping the same information I'm dropping on here. But I'm dropping it to you guys first because you guys are part of ATM Business for Beginners. So put some urgency into what you guys are doing and execute, okay? Go ahead and comment automation if you would like one of my team members to reach out to you so then they could possibly put you on the waiting list, guys. So you guys are the first ones to get an informational call and you're able to execute. Go ahead and comment automation right now in the comments. That's going to be AUTOMATION, automation now. You guys are getting first dibs on this, okay? All right. And that's all I got for you guys. A little bit longer than expected, but we have to provide value to you guys so you guys know exactly what you're doing and you don't step on your own foot like I did. So
it's 100% true. Phenomenal presentation, Paul. I mean, I'm all about keeping things simple, making things happen, but I mean, you can get all the tools in the world. It's kind of like you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make them drink. You can get all the tools, bounce passes. Steph Curry can throw you the bounce pass, but if you can't take it and actually take action and do the layup, it don't matter. And I'm absolutely all about action, man. Imperfect action when it comes down to it.
Imperfect action is what we always tell our guys. So whenever we have our monthly meeting, guys, okay, as the leaders of our organization, okay, we have to inspire our staff. We have to lead by example. At the end of the day, okay, I don't sell something I don't do. I don't make anyone do something I don't do. If I had one of my employees going like, well, what number have you hit? Well, guess what? I guarantee my numbers are going to blow your numbers. That's just the way it is. You got to lead by example, guys. All right. No prisoners. So with that, I'm going to leave it to it, guys. Can't wait to see you guys on the special IG. We're going to be promoting it all this week and next week, of course, on the weekend. Don't forget November 21st, 5 p.m. Pacific Central Time. Make sure to add my Instagram, Paul Alex Espinoza, and then Razo Vending. We're going to put it on the comments and make sure to stay tuned on that. It's going to be remarkable, especially if you've been looking for vending machine information and then also vendors as well, because Kwani got the connects. Yeah. So
just awesome. Give people's too. Yeah. I can't wait for that collab.
For sure. All right, guys. My name is Paul Alex, founder of ATMtogether.com.
Again, I'm Yona, COO, ATMtogether.com. Peace.
Have a good night, guys.